Everyone, and welcome back. Just a side note, I did do this whole section of video without my mic on, and that will be explained a little from a couple episodes from now, but as of right now, I am doing some post-recording work, and it's a little easier than doing live recording. It kind of gives me a chance to get my thoughts together. I'm not getting real distracted with the video game that's going on, and if I want to talk about something, I can actually complete the whole thought because I don't have to focus so much on getting everything correct. That is fantastic. So we are welcome back to Limbo. I know it has been a long time. The last time I uploaded that last episode was like, oh, we'll be right back. I'm having such a terrible moment. And then like 2 months went by, and or a month or something went by, and like I never enjoy my death montage, by the way. I never came back to recording it, and that's because I was really kind of playing a lot of Minecraft, some of the Sims, in my spare time, and I've been working a lot, or I guess I've been working average. We don't really get any overtime hours, which is, you know, and which is a double-edged sword. I guess you can go, we don't do overtime as full-timers at my job, my place of employment, and that's good because that means, you know, I'm only working my 40 hours, I'm coming home after it. I work loss prevention security, it can be a really high-stress job, and I get to come home, and when it's done, that's it. I don't have to worry about anything else, I don't have to do anything else. It's completely over with, and I can use my downtime to relax. You can also look at it as a negative, which is, you know, we don't get any overtime, so I don't get to bring home anything extra in my paycheck. This is, couldn't remember the controls right here, that's fantastic. You don't get any extra money during the week, which is kind of a pain in the ass, because we could definitely use some extra money, but things are what they are, and they'll just have to stay that way until I move on or move up or do whatever it is I have to do. So, it's Christmas time. As of today, there are 6 days left until Christmas. Yay. I guess. I'm excited. I got some cool stuff coming. Basically, this year, I got to pick all my presents. You know what you're thinking, you know, oh, don't you usually get to pick all your presents? Don't you usually, like, give, you know, when you're younger, give your parents a list, and, you know, they go and pick out, you know, what you told them to out of a long list, and you get some things, not the other things. Well, yeah, but this year was more like I'd asked for instance, boots, cool boots, and instead of trying to go and find them himself, my dad just gave me money and sent me to the store to buy them. And luckily, when I went to go buy them, there was a flash sale where I bought them, and it was like 60% off the whole store. So I got not only my boots, I also got two pairs of pants, and it was wonderful and fantastic and all that good stuff. But let me take a quick sip of incredibly watered down beverage because my ice is melting. So, stuff like that. I got tickets to go to PAX this year, which my dad was like, I don't know where to find them. Here, go buy them yourself. And then I got a couple of other things. And there are some stuff that I don't know about. No, I don't know exactly what it is. Like, my brother got me a desk chair, which is wonderful because it's sitting in an old kitchen chair that is, like, broken and the bottom's falling out. So, it was the worst. The chair's the worst. I was just watching I have the video up and playing in case I want to mention anything. I was supposed to say that was the worst moment of my life when that spider came up and there's the boulder and I'm like, oh man, I messed up on a puzzle. But, so yeah, so like I have a desk chair coming. I don't know, you know, what type of desk chair. And I finished my Christmas shopping last week, thank goodness. No Christmas shopping this week at all. Everyone else at work's like, oh my god, I have to go and buying Christmas gifts, like there's Christmas shopping, and our managers do 6 days through the holiday season for like 5 weeks, and that gives them a comp week that they can use. Or they do, 5 weeks for 6 days, they get rid of one day off, and they get a comp week. But, so they're talking to me, they're like, I had one day between here and Christmas, and I need you to wrap all my gifts and do this and that. And luckily, I'm still in the point where at 23, I get to buy one gift for everyone, and I don't really have anyone who, I have a friend who has gotten married, but, none of my friends have really started the whole, hardcore, marriage and kid thing, so I don't have to worry about, buying presents for, kids, and, my brothers, I only have younger brothers, so they're not married with kids. I have no nieces and nephews, and we're the youngest of my cousins, and my other cousins are, just kind of hitting that age where they're gonna start getting married, looking at it or seriously considering it. But, I mean, for the most part, we're pretty close in age, and at 23, I would think, or around that age for the younger ones in my family or the ones who are about my age, not a lot of people are thinking about really getting married and settling down. I haven't even managed to get a job that allows me to move out of my parents' house. So, there's not much that I have to buy for. I can still buy each of my friends one gift. Like I said, no children to buy for. No kids of my own to buy for. Nothing like that. So, I get lucked out that I only have to buy everyone one gift, which means I only have to wrap everyone one gift, which means I don't have 8 million things that I gotta buy for. Which is good, because other people are talking, they're like, oh, I have 14 nieces and nephews, I have my own kids, I have my god, kids. I have the godparents to my children who I have to buy for. And then the theme this year was really that no one, no husband and wife couple that I know, I pretty much only know the wives because I work I work with them. They're all like, oh, I'm not doing anything with the husband for Christmas. Oh, me and my husband aren't doing Christmas this year. Probably the only exception I would imagine would be the couples who don't have kids, or maybe have adult kids, but they don't buy a lot for. I know, my family's one of those weird families where we're all adults now, we still get 80 presents from our parents, so. Well, no grandkids yet, so I imagine, possibly, but not really, because a woman at my work buys the same way for her kids, too. A whole bunch of stuff for the grandkids, so. Let me tell you something. Working itself. When I went to school, I used to come home from high school, and I used to go, I know everything about life. You get like that in high school. I know everything about life. I get like that now, too. I know everything about life. I don't need to learn much else. That's sarcasm, by the way, guys. When you're in high school, you come home after going to school all day, and you get asked to do something, and your parents are like, I was at work, and you're like, well, I was at school all day. Well, guess what? Work, not like school. School, you can avoid people you don't like. Maybe not. Most of the time you can. But you can pretty much avoid some people you don't like. You don't have to sit with them in the lunchroom. There are a whole bunch of you, Unless there's assigned seating on the bus, you can sit with who you want to on the bus. At work, fun fact, if you don't like someone, you better hope the manager likes you. And you can look at them and you can go, oh man, please don't put me on the register next to that person. Do you hear her talk? She talks to every customer. We have this one guy at work, he just talks. He talks and talks and talks and talks and talks and talks. And he's, he's Greek, and, like, he smoozes with everyone. He's a big smoozer, and it's, you know, there's... So here's the thing. So you can be overly polite to a customer, you know, pack on the charm and everything, because they're only seeing you for, like, you know, maximum long transaction 10 minutes at the register. You know, compliments upon this, their sense of fashion, you can butter them up a little, make them have a really good experience, and then they're gone. And we're thinking, that person was so nice. When you work with someone, you see them like 30 hours out of a week, and they're just kissing your butt like you wouldn't believe. You're sitting there going, I don't actually believe you. Like, for a while this guy was calling me boss, cause she's my boss, that's, you know, and I was like, I am not, I am the furthest thing from your boss.